At least 20 are dead and 5 million affected following severe flooding in Bangladesh. The floodwaters have left many communities isolated and in urgent need of food, water and medicine, particularly in remote areas where blocked roads have hampered rescue and relief efforts. The country's weather agency has warned the floods could persist if the monsoon rains continue, as water levels are receding very slowly. Updates from the Philippine city of Davao, where state forces and followers of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy are engaged in a fierce standoff. Police gave Quiboloy supporters an ultimatum to disperse their blockade at the Kingdom of Jesus Christ compound. The crowd refused to budge despite the threat of arrest. Police are now working on dismantling the scaffolding that the protesters used to block the roads. KOJC members set up their barricade to prevent the police from serving arrest warrants against Quiboloy. The pastor is wanted for sexual abuse and trafficking charges. He's also on the U.S. Federal Bureau of Investigation's most wanted list. Davao police earlier insisted Quiboloy remains holed up in the KOJC compound.
Ang hinahanap na lang po talaga natin is yung entrance po ng bunker. Kasi positive po talaga yung sa life detection device na ginamit natin na meron po talagang heartbeat sa underground. Hindi lang naman po isang heartbeat ang naano natin, ang na-detect. And then very positive po yung information na receive namin na nasa loob talaga po ng KOJC compound si Quiboloy at yung mga kasama niya po. And then sa actions po ng mga members ng KOJC na naging agresibo sila, violente, merong mga structures na ayaw nila kaming papapasukin, indicates na meron talaga silang tinatago. Hindi po sila nagko-cooperate.
Dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go has not attempted to leave Indonesia since last week. That's according to the Philippine Immigration Bureau. Its spokesperson Dana Sandoval says their Indonesian counterpart Saul Go last entered Indonesia on August 18. She adds Go and her family did not go through the proper immigration procedures, as Sheila Go's passport did not contain any immigration markings. Meanwhile, Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatalyan says Manila has alerted other Southeast Asian countries to be on the lookout for Go. According to Gatalyan, ambassadors of ASEAN countries assured him that local authorities are also on the lookout for the former mayor. The sister of dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go, now detained at the Senate. The upper chamber sergeant-at-arms said Sheila Go underwent inventory and medical checkup upon her arrival. Guo is set to face a joint Senate panel hearing on illegal offshore gaming hubs Tuesday. Guo's lawyer, attorney Stephen David, says his client is ready to cooperate with a Senate probe and tell the truth.
Ang masasabi ko, ready siya. Basta advice ko, magsabi lang siya ng totoo. Yung katotohanan, yun ang magpapalaya sa kanya.
Meanwhile, Cassandra Ong is now under the custody of the House of Representatives. Ong arrived at the Batasang Pamansa complex Monday afternoon. Her lawyer, meanwhile, says they're planning to file arbitrary detention complaints against the arresting officers, as he claims Ong's detention has no legal basis.
The Philippines now focus on strengthening its defense systems to deter an armed attack by China. Those remarks from Defense Secretary Gilberto Teodoro on the sidelines of the country's observance of National Heroes Day. Teodoro said Manila should be ready to anticipate such behavior from Beijing, since China does not care about protests submitted by the Philippines over its previous aggressions.
Let us deter an armed attack. That is the more important thing, and that is what I focused on doing. Everybody's too focused on armed attack. Let's make ourselves strong enough so that that does not happen.
The Philippine military, meanwhile, said it conducted a test of its own flares last week. Armed Forces Chief Romeo Bronner Jr. said this was carried out on August 23rd, as he insists China's use of flares against a Philippine aircraft was an escalation of the maritime row.
For us, no? For us, it is a dangerous maneuver. Kasi pag yung flares tumama sa atin, that's very dangerous. Gumagana yung mga flares natin. So we have that capability, but then again, because we follow international laws, hindi natin ginagawa yon sa iba.